government is keeping former President Arroyo in the country because of electoral sabotage charges.
But Teddy Roxham Jr. believes it would be best to do otherwise.
Thank you. I think GMA should be made to escape. To be sure, flight is just a sign and not a proof of guilt. It may be a sign of fear of unfairness. Ping Lacson fled the charge of double murder. He denied it in more detail than the cops revealed. But he said he would not get a fair trial under GMA. He was, he said, a fugitive from injustice. But for a certain mentality, flight is proof of guilt beyond any reasonable doubt about it. Despite rumors she owns all or chunks of some of the top 10 corporations, government has only one case against GMA. It involves two choppers in the name of Archie Po, who bought the choppers, kept them in his name, insured the choppers, and sold them to the PNP as brand new. It makes sense that the only criminal clearly responsible should be the best witness of the crime he committed. Since Noynoy vowed to jail GMA by Christmas, I hope he means after conviction, do we want GMA sticking around to defend herself? No. We want her out of country, confessing by her flight her guilt of weak charges. Her defense panel will surely lose heart. Attorney Topacio, at least one of his eggs. By default, the prosecution will carry the day. We can also harass her to death, but that may cause dismissal of the cases. Meanwhile, government can sequester some, if not all, these top 10 corporations or the shares possibly pertaining to her. I will not mention them by name. Suffice it to say that one of them sells beer, another or the same one electricity. Another is a bank. There is the national grid, a telecoms company, lots more. I have this on the authority of respected businessmen whose names I forbear to reveal. This approach of sending her out and keeping her away has several advantages. The best one alone deserves to be mentioned. It will open up a couple of seats on the boards of some of the top 10 but suspect corporations for PCGG nominees. By the time an intelligent court justly adjudicates these cases or a normal prosecution withdraws, government will have had for 5 years, if not control, its hands in the pockets of the top 10 suspect corporations allegedly owned by her. Of course, there is no proof of any of this, but facts have never gotten in the way of a good story. And this story has been playing for 9 years with no sign of going away. If that is not sufficient proof in law, it is sufficient for public opinion. When the dust settles, Noynoy will be well on his way, out of the palace, out of sight, out of mind. Yet nothing will be lost. Not to the dummies of GMA, who are only dummies after all. Not to the public, which has no stake in these companies. And if they are not hers, then she stole peanuts. So the public loses nothing government could have taken away from her. But government will have gained plenty by their sequestration. Great idea, don't you think? True, this is unsolicited advice. But that is the best kind. Solicited advice is just flattery. I know, I practiced it. Whenever a president asked me what I thought of his or her idea, I always said, "Wow, I'm speechless. You thought of this all by yourself? Wow." Sip, sip. Keep well. Back to you.